About 6:28 this morning, a passerby had come down Andover Boulevard and 300 block of Andover Boulevard, and they saw smoke coming from one of the residents. They called that in. Anoka County Sheriff's Office deputies and Andover Fire Department responded. Deputies arrived on scene first and observed that the house was fully engulfed. Andover Fire Department arrived shortly thereafter, and Ramsey Fire Department, Ham Lake Fire Department, Oak Grove Department, and Ham Lake Fire Department also responded for mutual aid. Shortly after they had started trying to extinguish the fire, deputies had encountered an individual on the backside of the property. This individual was described as being in a sleeper type horse trailer. He was armed with a gun and making threats. So at that time, due to the safety of the firefighters on scene, neighbors, the fire department was pulled back. And unfortunately, as a result of not being able to work the fire, this residence has burned down to the foundation. Certainly in this kind of situation where we have a barricaded suspect threatening, due to the safety of, again, firefighters on scene, neighboring residents, we certainly can't leave due to public safety. So negotiations continued with deputies on scene. Ultimately, the SWAT team from the Anoka County Sheriff's Office was called in to take over that scene. Negotiations continued with this individual that was barricaded in the trailer. Shortly before 10 o'clock this morning, they heard a single gunshot. They later made entry and found one adult male that was deceased inside of that trailer. So certainly it's not the outcome that we wanted to hear. It's obviously a tragic situation for both the victim and the victim's family in this type of situation. The Anoka County Sheriff's Office, Midwest Medical Examiner's Office, will be investigating the death investigation, and the Anoka County Arson and Fire Investigation Team has been called in to help investigate the cause of the fire.
So we can conclude that this individual took a male, was that?
Yeah, this was an adult male that was in the horse trailer. He was the only individual that we believe to be at the property today. And we are not looking for anybody else. There's no other public safety concerns at this time. So the roadway has been opened up, or will be soon once the investigation is complete here.
So just to state it plainly, this individual took their own life.
I can't make that determination. The medical examiner makes that the cause of death. But we did, again, one shot was heard and male was found deceased.
Okay. Are you releasing any info about the subject at this time?
Not at this time.
Is this someone you've had run-ins with in the past?
We have had previous contacts at this residence. The details of those specific contacts I don't necessarily have available to me at this time, but we have been out at this residence before.
Okay. How much time did you spend, again, how much time did you spend on the scene here with all the different departments as well?
Well, the call came in, like I said, about 6:28 this morning, and then it shortly resolved right around that 10 o'clock time. So just a few hours.
Will there be any other updates today to expect, or anything more from Nottingham?
I'll be putting out a press release, basically the information that I'm providing you today. Until the Midwest Medical Examiner's Office makes a determination, no identification will be made until that's conducted.
Okay.